Hey everybody, it's Brad with the Big Family Homestead, and today we are talking about taking something that was, well, frankly, garbage and making it into something amazing. So let's get cracking. So over the course of the past several months, I've had some subscribers ask what this cross, this guy right here was, that was clamped up over on the back of my shelf over there, what this was, what the significance was. And well, the thing is this, the last time I went to Haiti on a mission trip, I was down there to film and document a ministry, actually two different ministries, no, sorry, take that back, three different ministries while I was down there in hope that we could make into something, the footage into something that could be used to raise funds to help them, because there was an orphanage and there was a medical clinic and a missionary team facility. Well, one day when we were working, because I was, you know, I would film, but then that's, you know, of course you're gonna help out building the houses or whatever it is that you're gonna do. But so I found this laying in the corner of a garbage pile, and it was discarded, I think because it doesn't look exactly perfectly, you know, straight lines, and I don't think that whoever made this thought that they were going to be able to do much with it. Well, I want to show you something. These particular pieces of art, and this cross actually, they were steel drums, the 55-gallon steel drums. And what those folks will do is they'll take those drums and with just basic hand tools and rocks, they'll beat them flat and they will pound them out flat, flat, flat. Then they'll cut them into the shapes that they want and assemble these amazing pieces of artwork. Now, they will then take these things and sell them to, you know, folks coming by, tourists or missionaries or whatever. They'll sell them for some money so that they can feed their families. Now, that's pretty amazing. But when you take a look at these beautiful, beautiful works of art that were discarded, they were just considered trash. And these folks were resourceful enough to take those things and make them into something not only beautiful and, well, frankly, just amazing pieces of art, but also then to take that and provide for their families. That to me is a life lesson that I need to hear specifically every day. So in our situation, and our family specifically, but I'm also talking to all of you out there, there is always something that you can do in order to make your situation just a little bit better. There's always a resource, there's always a way to make it happen. But what happens is we get so bogged down with all the, I can't do this, I can't do that, I don't have this, I don't have that attitude and mentality, that we lose sight of all of the stuff that's right around you immediately, and you can take those things and use them for your benefit. Now, that's pretty amazing, but the trick, guys, the trick is that you have to get in your mind not a negative attitude. You've got to get it in your head that you can do something. I can make my life better. I can figure out a way through this whatever problem situation you're in. And it just reminds me of those people down in Haiti that take trash and make it into something beautiful, and they make their lives better in the process, and they make their children's lives better in the process. And so this particular one reminds me that there's always something more you can do today. There's always something in your neck of the woods. I don't, you know, whether it doesn't matter who you are or where you're at, there's always a way that you can make something a little more beautiful, a little more awesome, make life a little better. But it's got to start up here. It's got to start when you switch on the mental attitude of thinking positively. And so really that's it. Short video today, but I wanted to share that with you. And so there you have it, guys. I am Brad with the Big Family Homestead. You guys have an amazing day.